All thanks and praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek His help and His forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of ourselves and the consequences of our evil deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can misguide, and whosoever Allah leads astray, none can guide. I bear witness there is no God but Allah alone, without any partners, and I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His servant and messenger. Allah the Exalted said, O you who believe, fear Allah as He should be feared, and do not die except as Muslims in submission to Him. Allah the Exalted said, O mankind, fear your Lord who created you from one soul and created from it its mate and dispersed from both of them many men and women. And fear Allah through whom you ask one another and the wounds. Verily Allah is watching over you. And the Exalted said, O you who have believed, fear Allah and speak words of appropriate justice. He will then amend you for your deeds and forgive your sins. And whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger has certainly attained a great attainment. Verily the most truthful speech is the Book of Allah, and the best guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst affairs are newly invented matters in religion. Every newly invented matter in religion is an innovation, and every religious innovation is a misguidance. To proceed. Allah, may He be glorified and exalted, commanded His Prophet, peace be upon him, to acquire knowledge, and said to him, وَقُلْ, and say, رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا, my Lord, increase me in knowledge. Imam al-Razi has explained this verse by saying, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded His Prophet to rush to the gaining of knowledge, which is found in the complete pages of the Qur'an, and what was revealed upon him. From this verse, we can tell that such a great, great emphasis has been placed on educating oneself in regards to his religious affairs. Nay, in fact, it is a command on every Muslim to know at least the compulsions of his religion. Because if you don't know your compulsions, how are you to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the correct way? You will fall into what the Nasara, the Christians, have fallen into. Yet today we find ignorance widespread amongst the masses of the Muslims and in many of the Muslim countries. My dear brothers and sisters, strange it is that you find a person with so many worldly certificates that his briefcase is overflowing. Yet you find him, he might have a very prestigious job, yet you find him to be one of the most ignorant people in regards to his religious affairs. This man is like the one that was mentioned in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he said, Allah hates the one who is rude and glutton, which is translated as an excessively greedy eater, who shouts in the marketplace, who is a rotten corpse by night by not praying his tahajjud prayers, and who works like a donkey by day. But this is the part that I want the brothers and sisters to concentrate on, is knowledgeable in worldly matters and ignorant of matters of the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates these people. Allah and His Prophet condemn these people by condemning ignorance in the religion. My dear brothers and sisters, let us all have a good look at ourselves. Where do we stand? Are we the people who are knowledgeable in worldly matters and ignorant in the matters of the hereafter and the deen? And let us all be honest. With the spread of an advancement in technology, you can literally access any sort of Islamic knowledge in the palm of your hand. Yet we still find amongst the Muslims ignorance at its most extreme. Wallahi, this comes down to three things: laziness, disobedience, and following one's own desires. It shows weakness of faith that how a person can be ignorant of matters and affairs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made compulsory upon him to know. That how we can worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out of ignorance. Allah has commanded us to seek refuge in Him from the conditions of the Christians. Those whom Allah described as the lost, the misguided, the ignorant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين انعمت عليهم. Guide us to the straight path, the path of those whom you have favored. غير المغضوب عليهم, not the path of those whom earn your anger. And this is a reference to the Jews who knew but didn't put into practice what they knew. What of Balin, nor of those who go astray. And this is a reference to the Christians who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in ignorance or in a state of ignorance. Both of these groups are doomed in the hereafter. And it is narrated that Umar al-Faruq, during his khilafah, in one of the nights passed by a light illuminated from a window. So he asked, whose house is this? He was told that his companion said to him, it is a house that belongs to a Christian priest. He then asked, what is he doing? His companions told him, the priest is praying. So Umar radiallahu anhu started to weep. He was asked, what has made you weep, Amir al-Mu'mineen, O leader of the believers? He said, out of mercy for that priest. He was then asked, surprised, do you show so much mercy for him and he is a disbeliever? Umar radiallahu anhu replied, وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ خَاشِعَةٌ. Some faces that day will be humiliated. عَامِلَةٌ نَاصِبَةٌ. Laboring hard in this world, in action which are no benefit to them. Weary on the day of judgment they will come. Only to be told, تَصْلَى نَارًا حَامِيَةً. They will enter into the blazing fire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from the ignorance of the Christians. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. Prophet ﷺ related to us that one of the signs of the hour would be widespread ignorance. He said, may the peace and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon him. Ahead of the hour, there will be days in which knowledge is taken away and ignorance will prevail. In another hadith, he said to us, there will come a time when people will not know what prayers, fasting, charity. I pray to Allah that we not see such times and thank Him that we are still in the time where knowledge is abundant if searched for. And many scholars are still amongst us. My dear brothers and sisters, it is time to sincerely and seriously start attending circles of knowledge, whether it be in the form of a lecture, a workshop, or the Friday khutbah. It is time we educated ourselves in the affairs of our religion, starting with the compulsions and the obligations, using all that we have at our disposal, from the internet to Islamic material in the form of books and so on. Seeking knowledge is a form of worship, so it will not go unrewarded. The Prophet ﷺ praised the one who seeks knowledge and said, من سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما سهل الله به طريقا الى الجنه. Whosoever takes the path to seek knowledge, Allah will make the path to paradise easy for him. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from the one who seek knowledge. فأيها الإخوة المؤمنون أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله فإن خير الزاد التقوى. واعلموا أيها الإخوة المؤمنون أن الله سبحانه وتعالى أمرنا بالصلاة والسلام على نبيه فقال عز وجل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى علي واحدة صلى الله عليه عشرا. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة والتابعين. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك, ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك, ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. اللهم متعنا بأسماعنا أبصارنا وقواتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا. اللهم اجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عادانا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الكفرة والمشركين. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في كل مكان الذين يجاهدون في سبيلك لتكون كلمتك هي العليا وتكون كلمة الذين كفروا هي السفلى. إن الله يأمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة. Thank you.